So Anna will be speaking to you first.
So we are the cluster statistics group, and first we were solving problems together to get to know the subject better, and after we formed two research groups. So there will be a 20-minute talk about what we learned during solving the problem set, and after 2 10-minute talk about the two research groups. So first, let me tell you what is a CSP, cluster satisfaction problem. So for example, if we have a graph, it's reasonable to ask whether we can color it with 3 colors in a way that if two nodes connected with an edge, their color has to be different. So we can rephrase this problem. So if we have, we can have variables at the nodes, and if we have a variable which is a pair of variables which is an edge, then there should be in this relation because 0, 1, and 2 are the colors. So we are looking for a solution function like this f here, which maps the variables to the colors and tell us how should we color the nodes in a way that they are, will be in this relation. And another example is the two-set problem, where we have a conjunction of closes. And in every close, there is at most 2 variables, and both of them can be negated. And here, the universe is 0, 1. Like before, the universe was the 3 colors. And here, it's 0, 1, true or false. And we can rephrase it to in a way of relations. So for example, this Z is standing alone here, that this whole formula has to be true. So Z has to be in the one relation. And if one is negated and standing alone, it has to be in the zero relation. And for example, the first close has to be in the relation where it's all the binary relations but the 0, 1. Because if X is 1, then we are good. And if Y is 0, we are good too. But if both of them are 0 and 1, it's the only way when it's not, the formula is not satisfiable. So after these examples, it's the general definition. So we say we have a relational structure when we have a universe, like the colors and the true or false. And we have some relations on it. And every relation is, so if you have a K-Ary, sorry, relation, it means that we have a K-tuple, where every member of the tuple is in the universe A. So if we have a set of relations and the universe, we have a relational structure. And if we have a relational structure, we can have its CSP, which means that we have a set of variables and a set of constraints. And the constraints are looking like we have some tuples of the variables, which has to be in some of the relations. So it's like a constraint if we formalize it. And the question to find a solution function, like the coloring, at the first example, in a way that all the constraints are satisfied. And the question, the real question, whether we can decide it in polynomial time, or what's the complexity of this question, because we can just check all the possible mappings if we have a lot of time. So by the end of the problem sets, we were able to prove Schaeffer's theorem, which says that if the universe is the 0, 1, then either CSP A is very hard and be complete. If we can solve it, we can solve anything with everything with the universe of 0, 1, or it's B times solvable. But to reach that result, first we should get the polymorphism. So let me define polymorphism. So if we have, so we have an n-ary operation and we have an m-ary relation. So there are the m tuples. And we will put it in a matrix where there is the lots of columns n. So we can apply our operation to the column because we have n members here. So we can write here what we get, like f1. And this operation is a polymorphism if it has the following property. If every row m tuples using the relation, then we applied f, then what we get down here, this m tuple has to be in the relation too. So if f knows that, then it's a polymorphism over this relation R. And if it's a polymorphism over every relation in the relational structure, then it's a polymorphism of the relational structure. Yeah, so for example, projections are always polymorphism because the case projection just take the case. So the case projection assign the case element from the numbers there. So the case projection just will copy the case rule there. And we know that it was in R. So what we get done there, it has to be in R too. So it's always a polymorphism. And they are the only function which are polymorphism of every relational structure. So we call them the trivial polymorphism. Now I want to show you some non-trivial polymorphism of some relational structure. So for example, if we have a single zero and one relation and all the binary relation, this majority function preserve all of them. So that means that for the tuple, for example, for the tuple 100, it assigns zero. So I will prove it. So first, it preserves zero because for the all zero column, it's assigned zero, and for the all one column, it assigns one. And if we have, so we have binary relations, so we are looking for the binary, some binary relation R, and we have a ternary operation, so it's 3 times 2, the matrix, and we apply F there, and we get something like A and B. So if we got A, that means that at least two places there is A. If we had, because of the majority property, and if we get B there, that means that at least two places there is a B somewhere. But it's 4 places for 3. So by Prigent-Hopf principle, there will be a row of A and B. So it was in R, and it has to be in R too because of that. So it's a polymorphism over all the binary relations. The other one is a ternary addition modulo 2. So for example, to 1, 1, 0, it assigns 1 plus 1 plus 0, which is 0 modulo 2. And it will preserve this R relation, because in this relation, R tuples where their sum is exactly 1 modulo 2. You can see. So if we have something like this, 3 times 3 matrix, where we apply F. So if these are in R, that means that the sum of these tuples is exactly 1 modulo 2. So after that, we apply this operation. That means that we add the columns here. So for example, there. And the question is whether it's in R. So we can decide it in a way that we add them together, and we should check whether it's 1. But it's 1 because the sum of these rows are 1, and we add them together. So it will be 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is 1 modulo 2. So it will be in R too. So it's a polymorphism. And polymorphisms are closed under composition. For example, if we have two binary operation, then we can put them together for get ternary operation, for example, in a way. And it will, if the two binary operation were polymorphism of a relational structure, then it's very easy to check that this ternary operation will be a polymorphism too. It's the same idea is working for the general case, so it's very easy to prove. We prove that polymorphism contains all the projections, and they are closed under composition. And definition for clone is the same two property. So we have a unique